So before I start this video today, I want to go ahead and let everybody know that there's gonna be spoilers in this video. I already beat the game. This is already my second playthrough. I'm playing it on hardcore now. So obviously I'm gonna have footage of the game in this video. There's probably gonna be spoilers. If you haven't played Resident Evil 4, you know, like the original or the remakes, please don't watch this. Just wait to If you are thinking of playing the Resident Evil 4 remake, you should wait and then, you know, watch this video later. If you haven't played, and on top of that, if you haven't played the Resident Evil, the original one at all, then yeah, I recommend not to watch this video at all because there's gonna be spoilers in this video, especially if you are planning on playing this game. So pretty much, I want to go ahead and give my first thoughts on this game. I already beat it, like I said before. I'm already on my second playthrough on hardcore, and yeah, pretty much I started playing the second playthrough right away after I beat the first playthrough. This game is really good. It was a really, really, really good remake. I can just let you know that there are some things that are not in the game, but it's not like the Resident Evil 3 remake when they kind of cut out a lot of important and you know, good scenes, good moments from the original. Not in this one, to be honest. I feel like the stuff that they cut out, it was either probably for, you know, because of technical issues or stuff that they didn't really need to be there. You know, and what I mean by that, like the lift is not really there. That's not there in this game. The UT, the U3 monster boss fight, you know, the one that you fight in the cage in the original, it's not there either. Also, the truck moment from the original, you know, the one that I believe Ashley's driving the truck and you're in the back shooting, it's also not in the game. But besides that, there's a lot of stuff that's in the game. Everything else pretty much is in the game. From, you know, thinking right now, I don't really know if I miss anything else that's not in the game, but that's pretty much, you know, the stuff that they cut out from what I remember so far. And yeah, this game, if you love the original, you're gonna love this one. It's literally like the original, but on steroids, in my opinion. The gameplay is just so much better. Obviously, the original came out around 2005, so even now that you play the original, it holds up really, really good. It's literally one of the best games ever made, you know, gameplay-wise, graphic-wise, and all that. And you know, it's really pretty long game. On top of that, if I'm not mistaken, it might be the longest Resident Evil game. Might be next to Resident Evil 5. I think Resident Evil 5 was pretty long too. But yeah, I really, really love this remake. I really do recommend it if you are thinking about getting it, especially if you are a Resident Evil fan. Don't be scared. Don't be worried that, you know, it's gonna be like the Resident Evil 3 remake, because it's not. And don't get me wrong, I really like the Resident Evil 3 remake. It just wasn't like the original. You know, the same feeling, the same magic from the original Resident Evil 3 was just not there with the remake. But it was still a decent game. It was pretty good. Besides that, the gameplay in this game is just wow. The things that you see while you're playing the game, you know, shooting people, the stuff that's been happening with the AI in the background, it surprised me. I mean, I'm literally on my second playthrough now, and I'm still finding all this stuff, you know, that's happening while I'm fighting enemies. Like this scene right here, that it just caught me off guard because, you know, this is where you have to pretty much hold back, you know, try to survive all this enemy coming at you when you're inside the house. And I just see this you know, one of the enemies just rolling out the chimney. Surprised the hell out of me because in my first playthrough I didn't get to see that at all. I don't really know if it happened, but yeah, in this one it did. There are bear traps in this game. They're almost everywhere. I also did notice that the enemy do put them down while you are fighting them. I actually noticed that on the demo. I haven't noticed that in the game yet, but I know while I was playing the demo, you know, one of the enemies put a bear trap while I was fighting a few of them. Besides that, there's a lot of like kind of world destruction in a way, you know. And what I mean by that is when you shoot the enemy and they hit the wall and there's something on the wall hanging that will fall or break. It's a lot of detail, you know. The graphics, when it comes to the RE engine, this has to be one of the best use of it. The game looks absolutely amazing. It just looks so good. And it's crazy because the Resident Evil 2 and Resident Evil 3 remake, they both look really good, but this one looks even better than both of those. I guess Capcom knew that they had to push their limit, because when Resident Evil 4 came out back in 05, it was literally like one of the best looking games, on the GameCube, and for any console back then when it came out. So yeah, this game literally feels like, like a next, gen game pretty much. And so yeah, just let me know what you think about, Resident Evil 4 if you have played it. And if you haven't played it, let me know if you're thinking of getting it. I really, really do recommend this game. Like I said, already on my second playthrough, ready to beat it again. Probably gonna beat it after that for a third playthrough, because I'm trying to, get everything in the game. So yeah, really do recommend Resident Evil 4. Thank you, everyone, and have a great one.